This is a part 1 video of the drugs used in dentistry series. Other drugs will be discussed in later videos.
Hello and welcome to Dentistry 101, your source for online dental education. We hope that you enjoy.
The expression of pain differs from one person to another. Treatment of the cause of pain is much more important than the suppression of the pain. Managing of the pain is a complex subject because all of the drugs have adverse effects. Studies have shown that analgesic prescription errors done by dentists are up to 30% in adults and were very high in children, reaching to 50%. These percentages could even get higher if the patients have a systemic condition. In acute dental conditions, it is recommended to take the analgesic as an injection because of its fast action. However, in chronic dental conditions, using oral route of drug administration is recommended because of its controlled release to the body and could last for a longer time. There are three broad types of drugs used to control the pain: the non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs, the acetaminophen, and the opioid analgesics. Opioid analgesics provide superior pain control. However, they are very addictive and are not prescribed commonly. This brings us to the other two broad families. The non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs, or the NSAIDs, provide an excellent analgesia for the moderate pain in dentistry. Drugs from this family include the ibuprofen, commercially known as Brufen, diclofenac or the Cataflam, which is also available as Voltaren injections, and not forget to mention the aspirin. All of these drugs are NSAIDs, which are analgesic, anti-inflammatory and antipyretic. If we look deeply to the mechanism of their action, these drugs prevent the production of the COX-1 and COX-2 from the body. COX-1 is responsible for the gastric protection, renal function and platelet aggregation, while COX-2 is responsible for the pain sensation and the inflammation process. By inhibiting both, the pain and the inflammation will not be present. However, because it also inhibits the COX-1 with the COX-2, there will be no gastric protection, which could cause problems or increase problems such as gastric ulcers. It will inhibit the renal function and it will inhibit the platelet aggregation. These are common side effects because of the inhibition of the COX-1. Giving NSAIDs is contraindicated in these conditions. Patients having these conditions are recommended to be given the other branch of the analgesics, which is the acetaminophen. These drugs do not inhibit the COX-1 or the COX-2. They inhibit the COX-3 inside the CNS, which gives analgesic and antipyretic effect. They could be given for patients having gastric ulcers or having bleeding or taking anticoagulants when the NSAIDs are contraindicated. The most famous example of this type of drug is the Panadol. Consuming too much of this drug could have a big side effect, which is liver failure. The dentist must differentiate between the intensity of the pain, whether it is mild or moderate or severe. Mild dental pain could be treated with low doses of NSAIDs alone, such as ibuprofen 200 mg 2 times per day. Moderate dental pain is treated by the full dose of NSAIDs. This is a list of the recommended doses for the NSAIDs drugs. Patients having contraindications are advised to take paracetamol. The safe amount of the paracetamol is 4 tablets per day, each tablet 1000 mg. To treat severe pain, it is recommended to combine the NSAIDs with the paracetamol because both drugs work together very well, and both of them have a very greater effect than doubling the dose of each individual drug. Elderly patients passing 55 years old are recommended to be given 3/4 of the dose because they have lower body metabolism and absorption. The NSAIDs could cause blood problems. Panadol or acetaminophen is better used. Elderly patients should be given maximum of 3 grams of acetaminophen drug per day. If they have problems in the hepatic function or are alcohol abusers, we should use the lowest effective dose of the NSAID drugs. As for the children starting from 2 years till 12 years, it is recommended to give the Panadol. The safe dose for the children is 10 to 15 milligrams per kilogram. Acetaminophen or the Panadol is considered to be a safe analgesic during pregnancy. NSAIDs could be prescribed in the first and the second trimesters of pregnancy. However, the best line of treatment for all the pregnant women is the intervention by the dentist to control the pain. Local dental anesthesia are very safe during pregnancy, and controlling the pain is much better than taking analgesics for a long time. Even Panadol could cause harmful effects for the fetus if taking for long periods. To summarize, all drugs are harmful and have side effects. The best line of treatment is direct intervention by the dentist to remove the cause of the pain or the cause of the inflammation. We should always recommend for the patients to take the least amount of drug to control the pain. The safest drug could be dangerous and have side effects on the long run. And this brings an end to our video, Analgesics 101. If you like the video, please hit like and subscribe. Thank you for watching.